And I had meatballs.
Oh, yeah, and spotted dick.
Yes, my lovely. What was your name? Stand up, please.
My name's Angela. I just wanted to know, I'm a bit of a daddy's girl. Are you a strict dad or a cool dad?
Can you be both?
No.
I am quite strict.
Yeah.
And I walked in from work yesterday, and I hadn't seen Daisy all day, and as soon as she saw me, she ran away and went, "Go away, Daddy, go away, don't go away! Mummy, tell him to go back to work."
Really? And do you ever allow them once in a while to have the kind of food that little kids love? Will you ever allow them a chicken nugget once in a while?
I'll make them.
You make them with
a proper chicken?
Oh, really?
Can I disagree with what you did? You know, you're saying about don't have turkey Twizzlers and all that, chips, because it makes kids lethargic and have no energy. I don't want these kids to have any energy, because it's me who they happy slap. They can't play. They give me abuse. I would rather them be knackered with turkey Twizzlers. I don't want them having any energy knocking on my door. Yeah, it's Becky, that is.
When you look back at your life, Alan, you're going to look at the things you've said on telly that changed the world and you're going to be really proud of what...
No, but do you think kids want to eat all that healthy stuff?
No, it's absolutely not. But where were you... Don't get me into this rant. Do you want me to go into this rant?
Yes!
Socially, where we are right now with, the family unit, going to work, stuff like that, the kind of food that's available in pre-packed kind of packaged solutions and all the kind of fast food and stuff like that, you know, what happens at home is so consistently bad that we have the most unhealthy kids in Europe. We eat more processed food than the whole of Europe put together. And the one place where we can change things, the one place where we can train the students to teach the parents, two generations of parents are coming in, is it? Fucking school!
I said don't bring up the chicken twizzlers.
You wait till I happy slap you later.
Thank you so much for all your questions. Brilliant.
After the break, I'm going to be trying to win one lucky audience member one of the most fantastic prizes. But first of all, I've got to choose that person.
Jamie Oliver, we want you to pick the person that you think looks like one of your TV cooking rivals. So, if Jamie picks you, it means that he's saying you look like Anthony Worrell Thompson or Ramsay. Bad times, but you'll get the chance to win loads of fantastic prizes. Good times. Jamie, off you go.
Let's have it.
Find out who Jamie chooses after the break. Welcome back to the climax of the Friday Night Project. Before the break, we asked Jamie to choose the audience member who he thought looked like one of his TV cooking rivals. Jamie, who is it?
Right, everyone that thinks they look like a TV chef, please stand up now. I'm going to choose you. I'm going to choose you. Have a look. Darling, who are you?
Delia Smith.
Delia Smith. Very good. You, sir?
Ainsley Harriet.
Ainsley Harriet. That's got to be a young Nigella, surely. What's your name, darling?
Jenna.
We're going to take Jenna. Jenna, come down.
Jamie, this is the Famous Five. Each category is either taken from the last 7 days of news or is based on you. For each one you get right, you win a prize for Jenna. Okay. Is all of that clear?
It's very important.
Is everyone ready?
Yes.
Then let's play the Famous Five. Okay, Jamie, first up is Pants of Power, and we're playing to win a DVD player. There's Al there with the DVD player at a Las Vegas casino with his girlfriend. Okay, Jamie, which celebrity went to a film premiere this week dressed in a Wonder Woman-style pants and tights combo that looks something like this?
Please.
I've slept with Jude Law.
Oh, Sally Frost.
Bill
You've said Sadie Frost. Let's see if you're right, Jamie. Sienna Miller. Next up is fast food, and you're playing to win Jenna a 10-megapixel Olympus digital camera. Jamie, you love fast food. We all know that. We also know you're quite a skilled chef, so you should have no problem cooking a tasty dish in 60 seconds. But in order for Jenna to win the camera, you will also have to eat it in the same amount of time. So, Jamie, please go over to the cooking area. Ian H. Watkins is there to help you. Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Let's get 60 seconds on the clock. Jamie, get cooking.
Right, pasta goes in, seasoned water.
What are we cooking?
Okay, olive oil in a pan. Ian H, put the basil into your Magi Mix, please.
What's basil?
I've got scallops here. We've got pine nuts going in. One handful of basil, half a handful of pine nuts. We've then got a handful of parmesan, and in there as well, I'm going to put one clove of garlic. And then I'm going to put olive oil just to loosen. You're going to take the lid off that now.
No.
We're going to give it a little shaky, shaky woo woo.
Get
the
bacon
here.
Does it need an ox or cue?
Fresh. No.
No.
We're going to go straight in here with some pesto. We're then going to go straight in with some pasta. Fresh pasta only needs about 45 seconds to cook if it's nice and thin.
Come on, Jamie, you're running out of time. You're running out of time.
Here we go. Let's plate this up.
All right.
Here we go. Fresh, fragrant pesto. Let's finish it with some nice baby
stop butter. The clock! Stop the clock! Right, stop the clock.
Okay.
Jamie, the meal is cooked.
Yep.
You have 10 seconds left on the clock.
Okay.
To eat the meal.
H is going to do it for me.
H is going to eat it.
H, you've got to do it.
The whole thing!
The whole
thing. Wait, H, you have 10 seconds.
Test the heat, wait.
Whoa.
That's too hot.
No cheating, 10 seconds to eat the meal. Start the clock.
Now.
Get it, Daniel H. Eat it. Eat it, H. Shovel it in. Eat it, H.
Get it in there.
H, just eat it. Time's up. Time's up. H, the time is up.
It's too hot.
Time's up. I'm so sorry, Jen. I'm so sorry. Jamie, come back and join us, please.
I'm sorry.
Ian H. Watkins. Sorry, my love. Go back to Jamie, please. Unfortunately, Jenna, you've lost out on the camera.
Sorry.
Thanks to the H. Next up is Beat Stephen Hawking. This time, Jamie, we're playing to win Jenna a mini theatre sound system from Bowers & Wilkins. There's Alan and Pete Doherty in rehab. Jamie, you famously played drums in a band. By coincidence, so does Professor Stephen Hawking. Can you guess which famous track Hawkers is singing for you now, though? Hawkers, let's have it.
I know it. Reach for the Stars at S Club 7.
Hawkers, what is it?
It was Reach for the Stars.
Congratulations. Jamie, next up, we're playing for the big one. It's a week's holiday for two in the home of your favourite cuisine, Italy. Jenna, you could be going to the Massaria Torre Caccaro Hotel in Puglia, courtesy of Citalia.
Yes.
OK, Jamie, we all know you're a cooking genius, so you should have no problem guessing a food-related phrase as we play Meal of Fortune. Welcome to Meal of Fortune. Before we start, please welcome my beautiful assistant, Nora.
Hello, Nora.
How are you doing, my lovely?
Fantastic.
Jamie, this is the Meal of Fortune wheel.
Oh, my God. Is that thing in the middle?
That's the centre of the circle. This is so degrading.
Okay, Jamie, as you can see, the wheel is divided into several different meals. We've got Twizzlers, we've got kebab, we've got takeaway, we've got the cricketers, your dad's place.
Yeah, my dad there, yeah.
Here's how it works. To win the holiday to Italy, you need to crack the mystery phrase on Nora's letters board. You give Alan a spin. Once he stops, you can guess a letter. If the letter's on the board, you will win that meal that Alan has stopped on. Jamie, you've got 60 seconds to play. Is all of that clear?
Yes.
OK. Then if you're ready, Jamie, spin the wheel.
Stand back, darling.
takeaway. Jamie, guess the letter.
E for elephant.
Quickly, Nora. It's E. It's on the, E. Brilliant. Two E's. Got two E's. Jamie, spin again. Come on, Jamie. Spin it. Kebab. Pick a letter.
T for tank.
Is there a T? Come on, Nora. Come on, love. Is there another T?
Hold on,
there's
wait.
Another T. That's it, Jamie. Spin again.
Oh, please, hurry up. Oh.
To win the kebab again. Jamie, another letter.
Please,
for a kebab.
Please.
Dog for dog, please.
End of that word. Come on, love. There is a D. Spin again. We've won a kebab. Turkey Twizzlers, pick another letter.
Oh, for-